بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. We should be grateful to Allah Jalla Jalalu Aman Walu who has given us Iman and given us all these solutions for problems in dunya and akhirat. A person who does not have Iman will pass the entire life searching for solutions in avenues which will be to their detriment. The people of Iman have this great ni'mah and bounty to have the ilm and the knowledge of deen, which is a great favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The shukr of that is that when we hear any amal, we need to practice on that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. إِنَّ فِي اللَّيْلِ لَسَّاعَةً لَا يُوَافِقُهَا رَجُلٌ مُسْلِمٌ. There is a moment in the night, there is an opportunity where a believer asks Allah خَيْرًا مِنْ خَيْرِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, any of his needs of dunya or akhirat, إِلَّا أَعْطَاهُ إِيَّا, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fulfill his needs. وَذَٰلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ, and this happens every night. So any need, any necessity a person has, there is a moment in the night, like the day of Jummah. Every night there is one moment where a person, when he lifts his hands in front of Allah, then his dua will be accepted. Ulama explain, before you ask, you have to submit a gift. Our gift is tahajjud salat with tilawat of Quran. Then when that salat is such a salah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy and pleased with, it's an opportunity to get our dua accepted. If we look at Sahaba, their entire life was filled with sifat and qualities. And it should not be that the people of Iman take pride on their qualities of dunya. If you have a certain clothing and it is branded, a certain bag and it is branded, a certain tacky, a certain shoe, a certain spec, a certain vehicle, are we taking pride on the brands of dunya and the sifat and the qualities of progress in worldly means? Or is my pride with regards to means of akhirat and sifat of akhirat? As we've seen Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, Hazrat Ibn Abbas once came to Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu anhu and he asked him, explain to me, describe to me the sifat of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So he replied, Rahimallahu Aba Bakrin, may Allah have mercy on Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Means, what a person. And somebody say, you love a certain car and they ask you about that car, you're going to say, what a car, and then you start describing. Somebody likes a certain team, so before you describe certain things, you marvel. So he said, Rahimallahu Aba Bakrin, Kana Wallahi Lil Quran Italian. He was perpetually involved in tilawat of Quran. And he stayed far away from deviation and transgressing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's limits ardently. And he avoided immodesty. And he was always engaged in preventing evil, stopping people from doing wrong. وَبِدِينِهِ عَارِفًا. As for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was well versed, he was proficient with regards to deen. وَمِنَ اللَّهِ خَائِفًا, and he feared Allah. وَبِاللَّيْلِ قَائِمًا, in the evening he was engaged in the ibadat of Allah. وَبِاللَّيْلِ قَائِمًا. These sifat that I mentioned were salient features of Sahaba. And sometimes we hear of incident, it was not just of one sahabi, but like our ulama explained, when a housewife makes rice and she boils it And when she sitting, so it's prepared, then she takes one or two grains and she feels it. If the two grains are soft, she presumes that all the grains are cooked. We hear one or two incidents of Sahaba, but it's an apt description of all of the Sahaba. وَبِن نَهَارِ سَائِمًا. And in the day he was engaged in fasting. وَمِن دُنْيَاهُ سَالِمًا. What sifat Sahaba had? وَمِن دُنْيَاهُ سَالِمًا. And how the Sahabi described, Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. How beautiful is the Arabic language. He was uncontaminated from the dunya. The dunya, he never gave dunya the opportunity to taint him or blemish him. وَعَلَى الْأَدْلِ الْبَرِيَّ عَازِمًا. And he was committed to administering justice among Allah's creation. He was committed. وَبِالْمَعْرُوفِ آمِرًا. He was engaged in enjoining good. وَإِلَيْهِ صَائِرًا. And he was always doing what was good. وَفِي الْأَحْوَالِ شَاكِرًا. And in all conditions, whether it was good or bad, he was grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلَّهِ فِي الْغُدُوِ وَالرَّوَاحِ ذَاكِرًا. And if you looked at him, whether it was morning, whether it was evening, he was always in dhikr, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِنَفْسِهِ بِالْمَصَالِهِ قَاهِرًا. And he was hard on himself on matters relevant to reformation, for his own spiritual reformation. He was always hard on himself. That's what they say, be soft on others, hard on yourself. فَاقَ أَصْحَابَهُ وَرَعًا. He surpassed, he excelled his companions in piety. وَكَفَافًا. In commitment. وَزُهْدًا. Abstinence. وَعَفَافًا. Chastity. وَبِرًّا. Virtue. وَحِيَاطَةً. Caution. وَزَهَادَةً. Self-discipline. وَكَفَاءَةً. Repaying people for the good that they do. Then he ended, may Allah's curse be upon those people who find fault and deride Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and find fault with Sahaba. So their night was spent in speaking to Allah, in calling to Allah. Mawlana Umar Sahib Palan Puri used to say, at night take from Allah, in the day distribute to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alaykum bis salati al-layl. Another riwayat. Walau raka'ah. Whatever you can manage, make sure you read. Ulama say from Isha till the time of Fajr comes in is a time of tahajjud. فَإِنَّ صَلَاةَ اللَّيْلِ مَنْهَاتٌ عَنِ الْإِثْمِ. It will prevent you from guna. وَتُطْفِئُ غَضَبَ الرَّبِّ. It extinguishes the flame, the anger of Allah. Sometimes a person is in a certain condition because of his wrongs. This is a way of making amends with Allah. And when we make amends with Allah, it'll be a means, inshallah, for that condition, that halat, that difficulty is being removed. وَتَرْفَعُ عَنْ أَهْلِهَا حَرَّ النَّارِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And it is a means of removing the flame of Jahannam, the fire of Akhirat as well. So a person needs to make a niyyah that I will do it. Then fix a time, fix a amal, fix somebody that will encourage us. يُحْشَرُ النَّاسِ فِي سَعِيدٍ وَاحِدٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. When the whole of mankind will be on one platform, it will be asked, أَيْنَ الَّذِينَ كَانَتْ تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ. Where are those people who used to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cry to Allah, Rahim Allah? If you want the dua of Nabi alayhi salam, if you want the mercy of Allah, then قَامَ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. A person gets up at night, he wakes up his wife. If she doesn't get up, or vice versa, then sprinkle droplets of water on them. You will get the mercy of Allah in the dua of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If a person has a lot of needs and he wants his needs fulfilled, مَا خَيَّبَ اللَّهُ مْرَعَنْ قَوْمَ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ, Allah will not disappoint a person who stands up in the darkness of the night in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want the love of Allah, then ثَلَاثَةٌ يُحِبُّهُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَضْحَكْ إِلَيْهِمْ. Those people who Allah loves is a person who has إِمْرَأَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, a beautiful wife, وَفِرَاشٌ لَيِّنٌ, a comfortable mattress. But he stands up at night and he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a person wants to be recorded amongst the sincere people, the obedient people, those that are not negligent, مَنْ صَلَّى فِي لَيْلَةٍ بِمِئَةِ آيَةٍ, read 100 ayat in salat at night. لَمْ يُكْتَبْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ, he won't be written amongst the negligent. And if you read 200 ayat, كُتِبَ مِنَ الْقَانِتِينَ الْمُخْلِصِينَ, he will be recorded amongst the sincere, obedient servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam himself, he should stand in salah, حَتَّى تَنْفَطِرَ قَدَمَاهُ, his feet used to become swollen. Aisha radiallahu anha said, I asked the Nabi of Allah, why do you have to go through all these difficulties and hardships? وَقَدْ غُفِرَ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَرَ, O Nabi of Allah, all your past, present, future sins are forgiven. You are ma'asum. Nabi alayhi salam replied, أَفَلَا أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا, should I not be a grateful servant of Allah? This was the Nabi of Allah. This was the Nabi of Allah. It should be a lesson for us. He encouraged, لَا تَدَعْ قِيَامَ اللَّيْلِ, O Aisha, do not ever leave قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. She says, he never ever left it. وَكَانَ إِذَا مَرِضَ, even when he was sick and he couldn't manage tahajjud, he made sure he used to read it even if he was seated. So this was the quality of the Nabi of Allah. We should see how close, if we declare love for him, how close are our lives to him. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud used to say, Maktubun fit Torah, in the Torah it is written, Allah has prepared for those people who stand up at night what no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard, no mind can fathom, no angel, no Nabi can perceive. Allah has prepared for those servants who stand in front of Allah. Some people seen Allah Jalla Jalaluhu in a dream, and Allah said, وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي لَأُكْرِمَنَّ مَثْوَى سُلَيْمَانَ التَّيْمِ, I will honor and give status to Sulaiman Taymi. They say, what was his habit? That when he read Salatul Isha, then he would read Fajr with the same wudu. He used to stand up the entire night in ibadah, in tahajjud, for 40 years. It was a habit of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. When people used to go sleep, you could hear from his house the resonation and the reverberation, كَدَوِيِّ nahl, like the buzzing of a bee till the time of Fajr. He said about Shaddad bin Aus, when he used to go to bed, يَتَقَلَّى, he would tremble and he would shake, like how when seeds are placed in a frying pan and we see the seeds shaking and resonating, he should tremble like that, and used to say, اللهم إن ذكر النار قد منعني النوم, O Allah, Jahannam has removed my sleep. Then he used to go and perform salat. Tawus, when he used to go to bed, he was a tabi'i from Yemen, a great abid. He passed away in the 106th year of Hijri, in Mina, yet performed 40 Hajj. Fayataqalla, he used to also tremble and shake and be restless. Then he used to get up suddenly and he used to read Tal Fajr, and his words were, Tarada dhikru jahannam nawm al-abidin. The remembrance of Jahannam has removed the sleep of the worshippers. Abdul Aziz bin Abi Rawad, when the night used to come, he used to go to his bed, then pass his hands over the mattress and used to say and address it, Innaka lalayyin, you may be very comfortable and I may be relaxed on you. Wallahi lafil jannati alyanu minka, but Jannat, there is a place that will be more comfortable than you. And used to continue in Salat the entire night past. Sila bin Ashyam used to stand awake the entire night in front of Allah, and when the time of Sahri would come, he used to cry in front of Allah, Ilahi laysa bimithli yatlubul jannah, Allah, there may be many people that seek Jannah, maybe I don't even deserve it, but one favor I ask you, Ya Allah, walakin ajirni bi rahmatika minan nar. Ya Allah, only through your mercy, Allah, only through your mercy, save me from the fire of Jahannam. The wife of Masruq, when his feet used to become swollen, standing in front of Allah in Tahajjud, she used to say, I should sit behind Masruq. And when I used to see him, Abaki rahmatan lahu, I used to cry because of the difficulty and hardship used to go. Today the Ummah, their hands become swollen, their eyes become swollen, their bodies become swollen, their muscles become aching because spending the nights in the masjid and the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us make a niyat, let us make an intention to change our nights from disobedience to obedience, from sleep and negligence to obedience. Junaid used to say, I've never seen anybody like Sirri. أتت عليه ثمانين وتسعون سنة. 98 years of his life passed and nobody seen him lying down except at the day when his death came. People seen him lying down. These were Rijal, these were the men of Allah. They left for us lessons. Al-Mughira ibn Habib said, I decided I wanted to study the life of Malik bin Dinar. So one day I noticed his actions very, very detailed, and I was following his actions. He made wudu after Isha, then he went to his musalla, and then he was holding his beard and tears flowed down his cheeks relentlessly, and he was crying in front of Allah, and he said, Allahumma harrim shaybata malik ala nar. Ya Allah, I've turned grey for you. Ya Allah, prevent this grey beard, this grey malik from the fire of Jahannam. Ilahi kad alimta sakin al jannah min sakin in nar. O Allah, you know the inhabitants of Jannah and you know the inhabitants of Jahannam. Fa'ayyu rajulayni malik. Ya Allah, I don't know, where do I belong? Wa ayyu darayni daru malik, whether I am destined for Jannat or Jahannam. Falam yazal dhalika qawluhu. And he continued crying in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until the time of Fajr came. He cried to Allah, Ya Allah, I don't know where my destiny will be in Akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq from being amongst the people who stand up in front of him in the darkness of the night. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.